The Haftorah starts with the words, that is the Haftorah of this week's of Parashat Toldot, is in the book of Malachi. And it's with the words that God is speaking to us, to the Jewish people. Masa dvar Hashem el Yisrael. The burden of the word of God el Yisrael to the Jewish people, biyad Malachi, in the hand of Malachi, the prophet Malachi. And God says the following, Ohavti eschem, Omar Hashem. I loved you. V'amartem b'meh ahavtanu? And you're asking me, how have you shown your love? So God continues, Haloi och Esav le'Yakov. Esav is Yaakov's brother. And Nu'um Hashem, in the name of God. V'oyev es Yaakov, and I loved Yaakov, Ves Esav sonesi, and I hated Esav. What is the meaning over here? What is God telling us? God is rebuking us for what? For having asked, Bame ahavtanu, where have you shown your love? And he's answering, Esav is Yaakov's brother, and I loved Yaakov. What is the meaning of here? The explanation is as follows. Malachi, he prophesied at the beginning of the Second Temple era, where we were mostly under the rule of foreign powers. Malachi is also the last book of Tanakh, so one could understand, one could reason, that he's talking to us in the concept, in the time of exile. So when God says, I have loved you, God is referring to the different times where his love was visible. Example, when he took us out of Egypt, when he took care of us in the desert, in the most of miraculous of ways, when he gave us the Torah in the desert, when he took us into the land of Israel, when he gave us the first temple, all times of godly revealed love. That was a time when we were privy to open miracles. But now in the time of darkness, in time of exile, we ask God, how have you shown your love for us now? We don't see it openly. And this is what God responds. Haloach Esav le'Yaakov. Esav is not Yaakov's brother, yet I loved Yaakov and I hated Esav. Meaning, I have chosen you over Esav. I have chosen Yaakov over Esav. The Alter Rebbe explains in Tanya, where does the concept of choice apply? When two things are similar, but one is something more about the other that I like more, obviously I'm going to take the one that I like more. So that's not real choice. That's I'm doing it because this is what I prefer. I need it more. When does the concept of choice really apply? When two things are exactly the same and I choose one over the other. Why? Because it's my will. It's the essence of me that is choosing it, which is beyond intellectual understanding. So God is telling us how he chose us. He chose us from his essential perspective. Esav and Yaakov are brothers. They're the same, equal. Yet he chose to love us. His will, his essence chose us. And therefore, we are one with his essence, one with God. So because of that, God says, I expect more from you. Because I love you so much. Because we have an essential, intrinsic connection. And we say to God, indeed, we chose you too, beyond our intellect. We said, Naseh v'nishma, we will do beyond our understanding. And this is especially revealed today in this challenging moment, in these challenging times. Schools are still closed and so on and so forth. Yet we cling to our relationship with God. We cling to our mitzvahs. We're going to do Shabbos and we light the candles and we do what we can and more so. Because God, our relationship is one of you chose us, we chose you. And as such, we ask you, God, please, we know you're present. We know you're protecting us, but we want to see it openly. Just like we saw the first Beis HaMikdash, we're ready to see the third and ultimate, infinite Beis HaMikdash with the imminent coming of Mashiach, so that we can light Shabbos candles today in Yerushalayim at 3:57, and they will blend together with the Neir Shel Tzion, with the Geula lights. If God forbid, we're still going to be in Montreal the Shabbos, we will light them at 4:01, and we wish each other Shabbat Shalom.